We've got a question which looks at process management and provides a user interface for the user. Pause the video, give it a go yourself first. Okay, let's deal with process management first. So what you've got to remember is that these processes or pages, let's say process one, process two, process three, they're waiting in line to see the CPU to be executed. That doesn't sound pleasant. And what we do is we follow a schedule. They're given a priority, so this could be the highest priority, which means that this dude will get seen first, even though they're in line. But if they have the same priority, they'll just go one, two, three. So process management allows the OS to manage the schedule of processes being executed or processed. Now, it handles the priorities, if there are any. But it makes sure that if there's no priorities, everyone gets the same amount of time. So this might get 30 seconds, 30 seconds, 30 seconds. This dude's like, yo, I'm not done yet. You still haven't finished doing like the loading screen. It'll go back to this one, this one, this one. So it'll keep looping until it's done. When it's done, goodbye. So it makes sure that everyone has equal time for processes. Spelled wrong. So it allows equal time for the processors. And remember what we said about the CPU. The CPU does multitasking. Remember, it's not really at the same time. It's not simultaneous, but it feels like it. So it allows multitasking. It allows us to go from this one to 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 this one, blah, 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 blah. So that is process management in a nutshell. When we talk about user interface, remember what we said about the OS. We've got the OS, we've got hardware. We've got application software. So it allows users to communicate, that means comms, with hardware. So it allows me, when I'm using the operating system, to talk to the RAM, to load up things, without really knowing what I'm doing. I just double click on an icon to load up a game. It launches it, but I don't need to have any machine code knowledge. Uses interface or GUI to make it easy for user. And I'm going to give you one last thing. Provides ability for user input. Think about it. If I'm right now on my keyboard pressing that, I've just inputted something into my keyboard, into the computer. And output. So when I press the start key, how do I know it worked? It worked because I can see my start menu. That's the output. It's displaying the result of what I've just done. When I'm pressing this pen down on my stylus, I'm doing this. How do I see it's working? Because I can see an output. The input is me doing something with my pen. The output is what I see. So these are process management and user interface management. Allows multitasking, equal time for processes, handles priorities, but the main thing is it allows scheduling for the processes to be processed. Interface allows users to communicate with the hardware, makes users the interface to make it easy, provides ability for user input and output. So let's begin this with a nice question. What is meant by an interrupt? I'm going to make this 2 marks. Pause the video, give it a go yourself first. Okay, so an interrupt is a signal. That's vital. It's a signal. It's a signal to the operating system, so it allows the OS to take a specific action. So for example, if I am running a game, and there's an error in the code, and a game crashes, it will send a signal to my OS to say it's crashed. My OS will then display a message saying, game crashed, would you like to send a report? Blah, 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 blah. It could also be, I'm playing a game, but before I'm playing a game, I want to print out, let's say, 300 pages worth of work. I start playing my game, all of a sudden there's no more pages left in the printer, so it's run out of paper. So it's going to interrupt my game, and a message will pop up saying, printer ran out, would you like to replace the paper? So it'll send a signal, and it interrupts my game, but that signal goes to my OS. My OS is like, okay, let's quickly display this message. Alright, pause the video, give this question a go yourself first, then let's go over the answer. Okay, interrupts can be hardware or software. True, it could be like your printer running out of ink, it could be that your software has crashed. Interrupts are handled by the operating system. True, interrupts are handled by OS. Interrupts allow a computer to multitask. Yes, because if we're doing something, so you've got your CPU, you've got a game, you've got your printer, for example. Interrupts occurs, interrupts signal goes to there. This then says the CPU, the printer needs your attention, so it goes from the game to the printer. So it multitasks, it can do multiple things simultaneously. Interrupts allow or work out which program to give priority to. No. Even though the printer running out of paper is important, it's the OS who makes the decision about priorities, not the interrupt. Interrupts are vital to a computer and it cannot function without them. True. Without interrupts, you can't multitask. Without multitasking, you can't perform lots of operations like we do today. All right, pause the video, give this question a go yourself first, then let's go over the answer. Okay, interrupts can be hardware or software. True. It could be like your printer running out of ink, it could be that your software has crashed. Interrupts are handled by the operating system. True. Interrupts are handled by OS. Interrupts allow a computer to multitask. Yes, because if we're doing something, so you've got your CPU, you've got a game, you've got your printer, for example. Interrupts occurs, interrupts signal goes to there. This then says the CPU, the printer needs your attention, so it goes from the game to the printer. So it multitasks, it can do multiple things simultaneously. Interrupts allow or work out which program to give priority to. No. Even though the printer running out of paper is important, it's the OS who makes the decision about priorities, not the interrupt. Interrupts are vital to a computer and it cannot function without them. True. Without interrupts, you can't multitask. Without multitasking, you can't perform lots of operations like we do today. Okay, pause the video, give this question a go. I'll go through a solution like normal. All right, so this question is asking you basically how do interrupts work? And it's giving us a scenario, someone's reading a text message on the phone, and they get a telephone call. How does that happen? Well, we should kind of know this already. Step one, the interrupt signal is sent to the OS. So there's an interrupt signal, goes to the operating system, that there's a phone call. The CPU will stop the task they are doing, they are processing. So it'll do like a halt. So if we've got the CPU, it's currently doing like WhatsApp, so text messaging, a phone call comes in. The CPU now has to deal with the interrupt. So CPU deals with, or processes, the interrupt. The CPU, to do this, uses what is called the interrupt service routine. So then what happens is data in CPU is stored in memory, so it's not lost. The user will get notification of call. After call, like the phone call, by the way, data in memory, like the text message, like WhatsApp, goes back to CPU. So it's simply, if I go back to the diagram form, CPU is WhatsApp dealing with like a text message, phone call comes in, the OS handles it, it tells the CPU to stop, the CPU will then move WhatsApp into memory. It allows the user to do the phone call. Once the phone call's up, WhatsApp goes back into the CPU. The CPU has to deal with the interrupt, which is the phone call, and it uses what's called an interrupt service routine to do that. The interrupt signal, remember, is sent to the OS first. Pause the video, give this a go first yourself. Okay, so give two examples of when an interrupt would be generated. So we know that you've got your hardware interrupt, and you know you've got like software interrupts. And the way I would answer this is to give an example of both of those. Now, a software interrupt could be like we had in the previous question, the phone call coming in onto a phone. So it could be like changing a task. So you could have mentioned like software interrupt. So I write the word software interrupt and then give an example, such as user using social media app gets a notification from another app. That could be an example of a software interrupt. It could be something along the lines of the phone call one. That's an easy example. It could be another situation. So anything which is basically changing a task from one thing to another. Or it could be user playing game, error in code, game crashes with an error message. That's another type of interrupt. Another one which we haven't talked about is dividing by zero. So let's imagine that you're using an app and the app is trying to do a calculation. And for some reason, it's trying to divide by zero. As you know, in maths, you cannot do that. And what happens is, if you try and divide by zero on a computer, in code, it will crash, creating a software interrupt. So an example, I actually did this for one of my apps, where it tried to work out a percentage score for a student. So normally, you would take the student score, which is like 8 out of 10, 8 divided by 10, multiplied by 100. But this student didn't do the test. They're still in the database, so they had 0 divide by 10 times 100. The problem is you can't do that. So it crashed because they weren't here for the test. It still tried to calculate them, their percentage. So it created a divide by zero error, which is a part of the software interrupt. You could talk about hardware interrupts, such as the easy one is the printer running out of paper. So you can write hardware interrupt here. Printer running out of paper. You could also do, let's say, phone battery dying. And the final one, which we can talk about, is you've got RAM. Address 1, address 2, address 3, address 4. And you've got two processors, two pages, trying to go into the same address location at the same time. For some reason, the OS does that. That will create an interrupt. So software interrupt example, a hardware interrupt example, you can talk about any of these. Accessing the same memory location for a process or for processors. You can talk about dividing by zero as an error. You can talk about printer running out of paper. You can talk about crashing in games. You can talk about using social media and getting a notification on something else. If the question was what can cause an interrupt, you could also talk about, this isn't doing that, but you could talk about things like using a keyboard. You can talk about using like a mouse. You could talk about error in code. So these are all direct causes. These are more examples of interrupt. Cause, example. Cause, example. So peripherals, input output devices is a big one.